Greetings everyone, welcome to the fifth episode of Churches of Wales Season 1. In this series, I take a look at buildings part of the church in Wales and covenanted churches in Wales. In the last episode, I looked at churches that are situated by the towns of Montgomery and Newtown, where I saw many beautiful buildings in settlements like Llandysil, Church Stoke, Kerry, and more. In this episode, I will be looking at churches that are situated to the north and west of Newtown, where I will be heading south to Llanidloes. I am Fabian Musto, and I present you the first season of Churches of Wales. In order to find these churches, I will use the Ordnance Survey map on Geograph as my reference for spotting church symbols, from maps of the 1920s, to maps of the 2010s and 20s. I apologize if some of my pronunciations of these place names are incorrect, since I am not a Welsh speaker. The first place I am at is situated 8 miles north of Newtown, and this building does not have listed status as of 2022. The name of the settlement derives from the saint of this church. The church building dates from 1865, when it replaced an earlier church structure from the medieval times. The only surviving features from the old building are the font and fragments of the screen. Situated east of that settlement is the hamlet of New Mills, and the building behind me is the old Methodist chapel of 1882. Built in the simple Gothic style, this was originally built in 1823. Situated 3 miles west of that chapel is the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel of 1872, which replaced an earlier chapel from 1790. This first chapel was associated with Lewis Evan, a Calvinist preacher that is buried in the south forecourt of the chapel. The monument to him was Grade 2 listed in February 1997, along with the chapel building. William Evan lived in this hamlet a mile north of Adver, and this settlement has a church dedicated to St. Mary. This was built as a monastery church for the Abbey of Cistercian Nuns, one of only two Cistercian women's monasteries in Wales. The abbey has long since vanished, and the site of it is possibly 200 meters south of the church. The monastery was founded by this person during the late 12th century, but the church building dates from the late 14th and 15th centuries. The east end window in the chancel has stained glass from the 15th century, but the glass was reassembled in 1891. Some of the glass was probably given by Richard of York, 3rd Duke of York. The roof inside dates from the 15th century, and the organ in the nave was manufactured by B.B. Edmonds. The church was Grade 2 star listed in March 1953. Situated south of the church is the old Baptist Chapel of 1842, which was converted to a private dwelling during the mid-1970s. Southwest of the hamlet is this disused Calvinistic Methodist chapel, built in the vernacular style in 1825. The Carmel Chapel was Grade 2 listed in February 1997, and the caravan park behind took its name from the chapel. Situated 2 miles northwest is an independent chapel from 1845, which is also situated south of a caravan park. This chapel was built in the simple round-headed and vernacular style, and was converted to a private house in 1993. That chapel is in the community of Llanfair Cyrenian, along with the old Horeb Chapel. This chapel is at a dead end in the rural countryside, and this chapel was first built in 1824, then rebuilt in the simple Gothic style in 1877. Situated many miles northwest from that chapel is this rural independent chapel of 1877, situated by the River Gam. This building replaced an earlier chapel structure from 1821, and is in the community of Llanerville. Situated 4 miles south from that chapel is another independent chapel, which was built in 1812. The building closed for worship during the 20th century. The chapel is situated north of this village, which had an independent chapel by the A470 road. This was built in the vernacular style in 1812, although the plaque on the building says 1826. The plaque shows five other years that possibly indicates when the building was altered. Situated a few miles east from that settlement is a rural hamlet, which used to have an independent and congregational chapel. Situated by a road junction, this was built in the vernacular style in 1884. The settlement had a Baptist chapel in the 19th century, built in the late 18th century. This was demolished in 1902. Situated north of Carno is the independent chapel, built in 1811, rebuilt of stone in 1898. This sub-classical style building is possibly still in use for worship. Situated northwest of Carno Parish Church is the Penewell Methodist Chapel of 1903, built in the classical style. This replaced an earlier chapel from 1811, which was remodeled in 1842 and 1861. This building was Grade II listed in February 1997, 5 years before the chapel closed as a place of worship. The parish church of St. John the Baptist was built in 1867 to the design of J.W. Poundley and D. Walker. The Gothic building is on the site of a medieval foundation associated with the Knights Hospitallers. The single-chambered structure consists of a nave and chancel, and the building has been renovated many times since it was built. One of these include the addition of battlements to the bell tower. The parish church is situated by the A489 road, and the interior has an inscribed stone in the south wall of the nave. This dates from the 7th or 8th century, and was rediscovered in the village in recent centuries. There are two chapels south of the parish church, and these were converted to private residences in the 20th century. The building behind me was built at the start of that century, and this was built as an independent Sunday school in 1904. This housed the Wesleyan Methodist Chapel for Carno from 1977 to 2002, when the chapel down the road closed in 1977. This chapel first opened in 1813 and was extended in 1863, then mainly rebuilt in 1892 with new features such as the entrance porch. Situated east of the parish church is the site of the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel, which was demolished by 2002. The building was photographed by John Thomas in the 1880s, and the building was used by the Young Farmers Club in the late 20th century. Situated northwest of Carno is an old Methodist chapel, situated in a valley with great views from the country lane south of the chapel. Built in the vernacular style in 1860, the chapel closed for worship during the 1960s, when springs underneath the chapel led to subsidence of the gable wall. Situated a few miles south of Carno is a rural Calvinistic Methodist chapel, which is by a crossroads. Built in the vernacular style, this also housed a Sunday school, and the building closed for worship during the 20th century. Situated by the A470 road are two former Wesleyan Methodist chapels. The first chapel was built in 1847 to a design by Eric Edwards, and the chapel was sold as a private building in 1875, when it was converted to a cottage. The second chapel, adjacent to the first chapel, was built in the simple Gothic style in 1875. The foundations of the building are the remnants of the structure, after it went into ruin when it closed during the 20th century. Situated north of those chapels is the old Calvinistic Methodist Chapel, built in the simple Gothic style in 1876. The building here closed for worship during the 20th century, and is now a private residence. Situated southeast of Clatter is the village of Pont Dolgoch, and the village had a Calvinistic Methodist chapel during the 19th and 20th centuries. This was first built in 1821, then rebuilt in the simple Gothic style in 1850. Situated a mile east from Pont Dolgoch is this fine village church, dedicated to a saint that gave the settlement its name. This was established in the 7th century as a daughter church to the Christian mission established in Llandinam, although the present building dates from the 15th century. The church was restored by R.K. Penson in 1863, and he retained the brilliant rood screen from the 15th century. The chancel screen is the best preserved of 30 known to have existed in Montgomeryshire, with the steps and rood loft intact. In the east end of the nave is a two-light window, situated in the north wall with fragments of stained glass from the 15th century. The patron saint is depicted on the window, although the glass was reassembled in recent centuries. The church was Grade 2 star listed in March 1953. Situated north of the church is the old independent chapel, built in 1896 to replace an earlier chapel building from 1827. The simple Gothic style building housed a chapel until the 20th century, when it was converted to a private house. The red brick Sunday school attached to the chapel was demolished in 2009, when it was replaced with a Gothic style building. Here is the old village church of St. Mary in Caersws, built to the designs of Edward Jones of Newtown in 1871. This was originally a chapel of ease to the mother church of the village church I looked at previously. The church closed for worship in the early 2010s, and was converted to a private house later that decade. Here is the third Calvinistic Methodist chapel in Caersws, built in the Gothic style with some Art Nouveau elements. Dating from 1912, this stone building succeeded the Calvinistic Methodist chapels of 1825 and 1871. The building plan includes transepts and large classroom wings, and as of August 2022 the building currently houses an English Presbyterian church. Situated opposite the building on Chapel Street is the English Baptist Chapel, first built in 1820 and rebuilt in the simple Gothic style in 1887. There is an old chapel situated west from the Baptist Chapel, and this was built in the 19th century. This might be the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel of 1875, and the appearance of the building has altered from its day as a chapel. Situated on Station Road is the Methodist Church, which is still in use as a place of worship as of August 2022. This was built in the Gothic style in 1875, and is adjacent to the Caersws workshops. Here is the parish church in this village, which was mainly rebuilt in 1857 for the Reverend Richard Davis. The rebuild of the church included features such as the west bell tower, south porch and north vestry, but the nave and roof were retained. The eight-bay roof dates from the 15th century, said to be the most unique medieval church roof in Wales. The east end window in the chancel shows Christ taking leave of his mother, and the west end of the nave has poker work panelling from 1893. This artwork was done by Edward Bernard Proctor from the adjacent hall. The church was Grade 2 listed in January 1997. Situated a few miles northwest from the church is the Bethel Congregational Chapel, which was originally built in 1851. This was rebuilt in the arts and crafts style in 1908, and the chapel changed denomination to an independent chapel in 1932. There is an old English congregational church a few miles east of that chapel, and this was first built at the turn of the 19th century. This was enlarged in 1810, but was replaced with a new building in 1848, which was renovated in 1889 and 1922. The building closed for worship in the late 2000s, and it was up for sale in 2011, where photographs of the interior were taken in April of that year. Situated a couple miles north from that chapel is an old Calvinist Methodist chapel, originally built in 1840. The building was rebuilt in the Gothic style to a design by Edward Jones of Newtown in 1888. The building closed for worship in the 20th century. Situated a few miles northwest from Newtown is a rural English Baptist church, first built in the late 18th century. This was rebuilt in the mid-19th century, and the building is set back from a country lane. Situated west of Newtown is a small Victorian church by the A489 road, built in 1864 to a design by Edward Jones of Newtown. The church is dedicated to this saint, and the building is situated between the A489 road and the Cambrian line. The Victorian building replaced an old church building on the site. Situated south of the church is an old Wesleyan Methodist chapel, built in the vernacular style during the mid-19th century. It was used as a store as recent as 2002, but by April 2010 it looked forlorn. As of August 2022, the site is completely overgrown. Situated by the Newtown bypass is the hamlet of Stepaside, which has an English Methodist church of 1868. Built in the simple round-headed style, the chapel has a capacity of 150 to 160 people. Stepaside is in the community of Mochtra, and the village church of All Saints in Mochtra is situated 3 miles southwest from Newtown. The church was built from 1864 to 67 to a design by Edward Haycock Jr. of Shrewsbury, and this building was Grade 2 listed in March 1953. The old church building on the site was established in the 12th century, and with the exception of the 15th century roof, it was demolished in 1864 when it was in a dilapidated state. Situated south from All Saints Church is the old Calvinist Methodist Chapel of 1823, built in the vernacular style. Situated east of the Mochtra Brook, the chapel closed for worship during the 20th century. I am by the A483 road to look at the Church of St. Paul in Dalvor, situated southeast from Mochtra. The church was built as a chapelry of Kerry in 1851, and a scale model of a portion of the roof was displayed at the Great Exhibition of 1851, in order to showcase the innovative use of terracotta ribs. The church was designed by T.G. Newnham, and the building was Grade 2 listed in September 1996. The church is also situated by the B4355 road, and the village sign for Dalvor can be seen by the west end of the church. The Dalvor Free Church is situated south of St. Paul Church, and this was first built in 1923 and rebuilt in 1987. Situated some 2 miles west from St. Paul's Church is the old Wesleyan Methodist Chapel, built in the simple round-headed style in 1878. The building closed for worship some time ago, and the building was renovated in the 2010s. Situated a few miles south from Mochtra is a rural English Baptist church, built in the vernacular style in 1850. The limewashed stone chapel has great views of the countryside to the northwest, heading towards Llandinam. Situated on a knoll above the A470 road is the parish church in Llandinam, which was established in the 6th century as a class structure. The patron saint of this church was alive at this time, and the church had daughter churches in settlements like Llanidloes. After the Norman conquest, the church kept its abbot for 2 more centuries. By the time the abbot left in the late 13th century, the square bell tower and belfry were built. This tower, along with the north wall in the chancel, were the only features not to be restored from 1864 to 65 by G.E. Street. The interior of the church has 2 fonts, one dates from the restoration by G.E. Street, and the other is medieval. The church was Grade 2 listed in March 1953. The village of Llandinam had 2 Wesleyan Methodist chapels, and the earliest one was situated south of the parish church. This closed in 1887 when the second Methodist chapel opened, but this Gothic-style building closed for worship in 1974, and was demolished in 1978 to make way for 4 houses. The earliest chapel of 1841 survives as 3 cottages. Here is a striking Gothic-style building south of the parish church, And this is the Bethel Calvinistic Methodist Chapel of 1873, designed by two architects that were based in Liverpool. The building replaced two earlier chapel buildings, and these were built in 1800 and 1823 respectively. The building plan has a schoolroom at the rear, and the building is used as an English Presbyterian church as of August 2022. This was Grade 2 listed in November 1996. Situated 2 miles northwest from Llandinam is an old independent chapel, built in 1863. Situated in woodland, the building was demolished during the 20th century, and the site of the building can be seen on Google Maps, satellite view. Situated 2.5 miles northeast from Llanidloes is the English Presbyterian Church in Oakley Park, built to a design by Richard Owens of Liverpool in 1876. This was built as the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel, and this subclassical style building replaced an earlier chapel building from 1825. Situated south of a caravan park is a former Wesleyan Methodist chapel, which stands on high ground south of the A470 road. Built in 1826 and enlarged in 1876, the chapel closed in 1978, and remained derelict until the 2000s, when it was converted to a private house. Situated a mile southwest from that chapel is the Baptist Church in New Chapel, which was first built in 1740. The building was rebuilt in 1815 and restored in 1905, but this building was destroyed by fire in 1954. This was rebuilt in 1957 in the simple Gothic style, and is still in use as a place of worship. Situated a few miles south of New Chapel is an old Chapel of Ease, built in 1826 to cater the more remote parishioners of Llandinam. The chapel has its own churchyard, and the chapel served as a place of worship until the 20th century. The majority of the fittings were removed after, with the exception of the font of 1822, and flagstone on the threshold that was a tombstone from 1717. The chapel is now in the grounds of Old Chapel Farm. Situated some 2 miles east is the last chapel I will look at in this episode, and this is the English Baptist Church of 1877. This structure is in a rural location, situated a few miles north of the boundary with the historic county of Radnorshire. The chapel replaced an earlier chapel building from 1846, and is still in use as a place of worship. I am at Llandinam Parish Church to end this episode, one of the oldest established churches in Powys. I enjoyed looking at religious buildings to the west of Newtown, and I will continue looking at them in the next episode as I head northwest to Llanidloes and Machynlleth.